Shout out to Hip Hop Is Real. It's your boy, My Son. Continue to do what you do.
Boy, now this guy, Hip Hop Is Real, Kill Life Production. We're here with My Son outside of the police headquarters and everything like that. You know, we brought a lot of people together, 6 feet social distance, in the house, quarantine, everything. But you brought the
Script,
people out
Script,
today, man.
Give Script one of those shirts.
What was so important to come out today, man? And bring all these people and have them out here with you and everything and making a stand today. Why was that so important today?
You know, it became more important. It was important. When I first seen the violence happen in our communities and I seen brothers being beat for sitting in front of their building, brothers being thrown to the ground, stomped, head stomped to the ground, punched in the face for coming outside to get some level of air. You know, just to get air, you know. We're dealing with so much trauma and stress. People are locked in their homes. They don't know if they have jobs. They don't know if they're going to eat. They don't know what tomorrow holds. And to go outside and be abused by the people who are supposed to protect and serve you, is an atrocity. So watching that happen over and over, and then seeing this man put down a mandate that we could not protest. This man put down a mandate that we were not allowed to protest. He was suspending protests in New York City after you do these things, and then you say that the protocol and the way that police are handling it is according to the playbook. It was a direct challenge to me as an activist. It was a challenge to me as someone who upholds the rights of our people to say, you cannot tell me to be silent about my pain. So I came out here prepared for whatever was going to happen. If we was going to be arrested, then that was something I was prepared for. You know, if we were going to be, had to be abused, whatever it was, yeah, it was going to happen.
I was gonna say, the demonstrations in today, what is it that you want out of this? You
know, we want our voices to be heard. We want them to know that we will not be silenced. You cannot take away our rights, our constitutional rights to protest, to speak up against injustice. You cannot allow, you don't get to tell us that. So whatever we have to do, because like I said before, Martin Luther King said, unjust law is no law at all. So we don't have to follow a law that is not just. So we came out here to let that be known to the mayor, to the governor, and whoever else needs to be known, the commissioner. That's why we came straight to 1PP. We're the police of the house, so they can understand that we're not gonna be silent. You know, we, like they said, we are anti-violent. We are definitely against violence, but you're not gonna just harm us in our silence. And if certain ones of us, if you grab us or you hit us in the wrong way, we're gonna fight back. So these things need to be understood. You need to understand, if you deal, like respect, like he said, respect goes both ways. You cannot disrespect me and then ask for respect. You don't get to harm me and I'm going to sit there. Everybody's not going to sit there and take punches. So, and if we don't get to a level of where there's some level of policing that goes according to the law, to where people are respected the same way they do downtown with a different hue of people, the same way they do in different communities, the same way they hand out masks, they should be handing them out of town and not ass whoopings. So we're not going to keep taking ass whoopings.
No, I appreciate you, My Son. Thank you for your time, man. And anything else you want to just let the people know, or they should be looking out
just
for?
Just listen, man. Don't be silent. Don't be scared. We're in times where this government and these people are preying on your fear. They're praying that you be scared. They're utilizing your fear of this pandemic to be able to control you, to be able to harm you, to be able to keep you inside and be silent about your pain. You don't have to be silent about your pain. You don't have to be scared. There's nothing to fear. You have the right. It is a God-given right. Forget the rights of the Constitution. You have a God-given right to fight for your existence and to fight for what's right. So make sure you do it.
I've been popping since 50 Cent did in the club. What she do with 2 stimmy checks, I do with a dub. She wanna eat, but she threw it all up. She need my food. Hey, so I'ma make it do what it does. What would you do if you knew what you could do with it, cuz? Why you mad at me? Like I released the COVID and tried to sell vaccines. Like I created this bill and tried to control that fiend. I just picked up the sticks and tried to play like me.